Ladies and gentlemen, the World Boxing Super Series main event of the evening is starting in 2 minutes.
Coming up now, the IBF Bantamweight champion and undefeated Emmanuel Rodriguez as he takes on Australia's undefeated and very tough Jason Maloney in a match that promises to provide a lot of excitement. Emmanuel Rodriguez, a lot of people very excited about this young prospect, says he reminds them a lot of, and these are the grueling tests that they will be up against. The winner of this fight will be facing Noaia Anoa'i, a fighter who put on a devastating performance a few weeks ago. And also on the other side of the bracket, we have Zolani Titi, who won a points decision and still awaits the winner of former world champion Nonito Donaire and Ryan Burnett. Let's take a peek at the tail of the tape between the two fighters. 26 and 27 years of age, both fighters weighted at 118 and 117 pounds. The height is very similar, as is the reach, experience, all on the same level. Maloney, supposed to be a big puncher. Emmanuel Rodriguez, very calm and very smooth in there. Let's take it up to Ray.
Ladies and gentlemen, the World Boxing Super Series is in the midst of our second season, as right now we get set for our second main event of the evening. It is the second bantamweight quarterfinal matchup. And now from Orlando, Florida, we present to you Emmanuel Rodriguez and Jason Maloney. The winner of the bantamweight tournament will take home the greatest prize in all of boxing, the coveted Muhammad Ali Trophy, named in honor of the greatest of all time, Muhammad Ali. And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the arena from Kingscliff, Australia, he is the undefeated challenger, Jason Maloney.
Known as the smooth one, Jason Maloney is a slick puncher boxer with 17 wins from 17 fights and 14 knockouts. Maloney comes into this fight on the back of the best win of his career, stopping the now 37-year-old former world champion Kohei Kono in round 6. The Australian is the underdog tonight, but has a good jab, swift feet and a big punch. Please welcome to the arena, Jason Maloney.
Jason Maloney now making his way to the ring. It's been a long way traveled from Australia. Now here he is, and he says the biggest night of his life, ready to leave Orlando, Florida, with Rodriguez's title in his possession. Jason walk into the ring full of confidence, twin brother behind him. This morning they said they do everything together, and he wouldn't miss his brother's big opportunity. Speaking with Maloney's trainer this morning, trainer Angelo Heider, he said the thing that impressed him most about Maloney is how stiff and hard his left jab is. Be looking for that tonight.
And now please welcome the tournament number 4 seed. He's the IBF Bantamweight Champion of the World from Puerto Rico, presentando Emmanuel Rodriguez.
Making his first defense of the IBF Bantamweight title, Emmanuel Rodriguez is the latest champion to come off the storied production line of Puerto Rican boxing. He nearly died in 2012 after being caught in a fire, suffering from second-degree burns to 66% of his body. The heavy hitter fully recovered and now boasts a perfect record of 18 wins from 18 fights. Please welcome to the arena, Emmanuel Rodriguez.
From Vega Baja, Puerto Rico, where Jason Maloney waits. People are very excited about this young fighter. Even talks that Rodriguez could be the next star of Puerto Rican boxing, after the likes of Wilfredo Benitez, Miguel Cotto, Felix Trinidad, and Hector Camacho. Rodriguez makes his first defense of the IBF Bantamweight title tonight.
Super Series main event of the evening. 12 rounds for the IBF Bantamweight Championship of the World. The winner of this quarterfinal tournament matchup will move on to take on Naoya Inoue in the semifinals. Your three judges scoring this bout will be from the United States, Alex Levin, from Mexico, Alfredo Polanco, from Germany, Holger Whiteman, and the referee in charge from the United States is James O'Connor. Introducing first, fighting to my left out of the red corner, he comes in wearing the white trim with the black. Official weight, 117.6 pounds. as a professional. He's undefeated, 17 wins, 14 of those coming by way of a knockout. From Kingscliff, Australia, please welcome the undefeated challenger, Jason the Smooth One Maloney. And across the ring, his adversary fighting out of the blue corner. He comes in wearing the black with the white and the red. Tip the scales officially at the bantamweight limit of 118 pounds. As a professional, he too is perfect. 18 bouts, 18 victories, a dozen of those coming by way of a KO. He is the number 4 tournament seed and is the reigning and defending IBF Bantamweight Champion of the World. Desde Vega, Baja, Puerto Rico. Damas y caballeros presentando, presenting the champion, el campeón, Emmanuel Manny, el sensacional Rodriguez. And here to give instructions once again is James O'Connor.
Boxers, you received my instructions in dressing rooms. Obey my commands at all time. Protect yourself at all time. Touch gloves. Good luck to both of you.
And here we go, a mouth-watering bantamweight matchup between Jason Maloney and IBF Kingpin Emmanuel Rodriguez.
It's main event time here in Orlando. Ray Flores, BJ Flores. My goodness, BJ, I am excited for this one. A berth to take on Naoya Inoue is on the line.
Already a nice straight right hand left hook from Rodriguez a moment ago. You see, gets a lot of leverage on those punches, Ray.
Rodriguez has a large amount of fans that have come to support him.
Maloney got stunned with that overhand right a second ago. He shot a jab and Rodriguez timed it perfectly and hit him with a pull counter. Beautiful shot.
Rodriguez has 3 rounds, has 7 victories within 3 rounds. So he certainly has quite a bit of power. Maloney, an 82% knockout percentage.
You can tell he's very physically strong as well. He gets in those clinches and you see Maloney's not moving around too much whenever he grabs a hold of him. Good counter punching from Rodriguez early, not taking much time to feel his opponent out.
Rodriguez started off as a baseball player before switching to boxing. He developed, became a prominence in 2009. He won silver at the Pan American Championships in Mexico. But he failed to get into the 2012 London Olympics.
Beautiful timing on that right hand, Ray. You see how he pulls out whenever Maloney jabs, how he pulls out and he's able to land that pull counter right hand. And he's also able to take a little baby step to his right side and also shoot a right hand and land it with a lot of accuracy. Very impressive. Maloney's having a tough time getting anything going in this first round. Smooth sailing for Rodriguez so far.
Yeah, Rodriguez looks very crisp on the balls of his feet.
No, he tricks you. He's over his front leg. And you think, when he's over his front leg like that, you think you can push the jab out there and he's going to block it, but he slips to the side and he's able to hit you with that right hand or the left hook.
Rodriguez is just 1 year younger than Maloney. As we near the end of round one, this has been a fabulous round to start for Emmanuel Rodriguez.
Beautiful right hands by Rodriguez.
Oh,
in the box.
And here is a big round for Rodriguez.
And we saw in many instances in that first round Ray, he was able to land that right hand. There he is pushing a straight left hand after the right hand. Great distance and timing from Rodriguez in round number one. Very impressive.
Round number two, this one is scheduled for 12. Emmanuel Rodriguez, the champion, defending his title against Jason Maloney out of Australia. Lisek Jankowak is the referee in charge. Double left hook there by Maloney, followed by a straight right hand.
Nice body shots from Maloney a second ago. You see Rodriguez, he's very patient, he's very calm. That temperament that anything you do isn't going to faze him. He's going to be okay regardless of what you do. And very good counterpunching. So he's able to be calm and be patient whenever Maloney comes with anything, counter with those shots. And eventually that will slow down the offense of Maloney.
A straight right hand down the center that connected by Rodriguez. The corner of Rodriguez telling him to keep timing Maloney.
Beautiful left hook. So much leverage on that shot, Ray.
Rodriguez is like a firecracker, BJ. I feel like he's ready to explode at any one moment.
Nice left hook by Maloney.
Maloney connected.
Rodriguez reminds me a little bit of a rattlesnake. He's always in that position where he's ready to strike. And, you know, you said it best, Ray. He's very, very explosive. He's able to react quickly. He's never out of position. Components of a good fighter.
The jab comes out for Rodriguez. It's the main event of the World Boxing Super Series. Next week, we will be in New Orleans for Regis Progray and Turbo Terry Flanagan. As we endeavor into 1 minute left in round two. Rodriguez, very quick. Maloney looking to try to create some space. And he gets clobbered with a right hand on the temple.
Rodriguez is so accurate with punches.
A left hook that connected upstairs by Rodriguez.
Maloney's so game, he got hit with a nice body shot, then a left uppercut, then a left hook right after that, and Maloney comes right back and tries to step to Rodriguez again, and that might be a recipe for disaster.
Big left hook by Emmanuel Rodriguez.
And the right-handed before the left hook, right? He got caught with both shots.
Look at how quick these bantamweights are, BJ. The winner takes on Oya Inoue in the semifinals. Inoue, who obliterated Juan Carlos Payano in Tokyo 2 weeks ago. As round two draws to a close.
That's the line.
That's the line. Beautiful.
That's really awesome.
Good man.
The last thing, though, you threw too big a punch with your chin up. No need for it. You're starting to work into the fight. That was a close round, that round, okay? Probably our round, but I want to say close.
Don't trade the left hook.
And there is now Oya Inoue, the monster. Man, oh man, BJ. in Tokyo, the electricity was off the charts. That guy is probably more popular than a pop star here in the United States. That is how big he is. He is Naoya Inoue.
Absolutely love that. I just love seeing, you know, entire country get behind their fighter. And, you know, look, he gave them the goods and he gave the fans what they wanted to see. So more power to him.
And Inoue stated to me in Tokyo, he wants Rodriguez. He goes, I want Rodriguez. That's who I want. I want the champion. Will Jason Maloney have other plans? We'll find out during the duration of this matchup.
Beautiful counter left hook from Rodriguez.
Nice right hand by Rodriguez. As Maloney with a straight right hand. Jason Maloney all week long. He has been so relaxed, BJ. He has been enjoying himself all over Orlando. You know, there is talk about Rodriguez being the next big Puerto Rican sensation. Discussions like he could maybe be the next Wilfredo Benitez, Miguel Cotto, or even Hector Camacho. Big right hand that connected though for Maloney.
Well, I'll tell you a couple things. You know, he's never going to be Felix Trinidad as far as, you know, the power and the excitement that Tito brought to the table every time, but he's definitely a very solid, very, very solid champion. You see so many things he does well. His balance is spectacular. He's always in position to counter. You know, one thing about I could say about Hector Macho Camacho, he was very good. Great hand speed, but he didn't have the fundamentals like Rodriguez. No. Rodriguez is very well schooled, and his fundamentals are excellent.
Meantime, for Maloney, he's looking to become the fourth Australian to win the Bantamweight Championship. Jimmy Carruthers, Lionel Rose, and Jeff Fennec held the title. Fennec held the IBF Bantamweight Championship between 1985 and 1987. And who can forget those epic matchups between Jeff Fennec and Azuma Nelson?
Oh, Azuma Nelson, the professor, was actually one of my favorite fighters. And, you know, Jeff Fennec was a very tough, gritty fighter as well. But those wars that he had with Azuma Nelson, I'll always remember running home from school and watching in my living room those tough fights. I remember Jeff Fennec. Nice that took from Maloney.
That caught the attention of Rodriguez.
And remember one thing Angelo Hyder said, who's worked with his fair share of world champions, Danny Green and others. He said, BJ, Maloney can punch. Don't go to sleep on him.
Well, Maloney is trying to put Emmanuel Rodriguez to sleep and then make his way back to the land down under. We hope you're enjoying this matchup as much as we are here ringside. Ray Flores, BJ Flores, no relation between the two. But man, oh man, are we certainly riveted by this matchup between Rodriguez and Maloney.
Nice counter, short overhand right by Rodriguez. Landed that punch very nice. He's very accurate. You know, you can tell he's not worried at all about where Maloney's doing or where he's going or what he's doing.
Left hook to the body by Maloney as round three draws to a close. And here is Jason Maloney having some success.
Nice short right hand from Maloney a second ago. And then here we see in a clinch, I think both guys look to shoot the left hook at the same time. Maloney lands on the neck.
And here is a clash of heads between the two. There are some tense moments between the two. There you see Jason Maloney looking to make history tonight and become the fourth Australian to win a Bantamweight World Championship. Emmanuel Rodriguez from Puerto Rico. There is a large Puerto Rican fan base out here in Orlando. Incidentally, Miguel Cotto fought down the street here in Orlando years ago against Delvin Rodriguez.
Beautiful left hook a second ago by Rodriguez. Feet are planted so nicely, he's able to turn on that shot. and get maximum leverage.
Left hook to the body by Maloney. And chance of Matty. They're echoing here at the CFE Arena on the campus of Central Florida. A straight right hand that got through the guard of Maloney.
Good body shots from Maloney a second ago, but you always got to be responsible after you shoot those body shots. Get your head off the center. Rodriguez came back with a nice counter hook. Nice jab by Maloney right there. Starting to get his way into this fight a little bit, but got to be careful for that counter punching of Rodriguez. Mix that attack up and down. Shoot some taunts. Shoot some feints. Don't let him time your punches. Don't let him get in that rhythm where he can counter punch you all night. Maloney's got to be thoughtful of that.
Rodriguez cutting off, or trying to cut off the ring on Maloney. As we are just over the 50% mark here in round four.
Nice counter left hook again by Rodriguez. He's so sharp with that punch. Right?
BJ, he seems to be a step quicker than Maloney. Just probably a step or even half a step faster.
I think the hand speed's pretty similar, actually. I just think the timing, the placement, the fundamentals of Rodriguez are making him seem a little faster because his timing is so good. Timing beats speed.
The corner of Maloney's imploring him. They want a nice stiff jab is what they are looking for. But again, someone who is as accurate as Rodriguez, that is very difficult.
It is, and the main thing Maloney's got to do to get his jab going again, he's got to shoot some right-hand leads. He's got to taunt and feint the jab. Take the timing of Rodriguez off so he can't time that with that overhand right every time. So, very important.
Rodriguez with a hard right hand that caught the attention of Maloney. As the final moments of round four draw near. And here is this Maloney jab that they are hoping to see more of.
It's a stiff jab, like Angelo Hyder said, Ray. He definitely landed good, but you know, later in the round we see Rodriguez getting some more good work in. See, Maloney was almost missed a shot there and Rodriguez missed, but a lot of good exchanges in that last round. Both guys had their moments, and there's Maloney again with a nice straight right hand.
There's a little bit of some bruising above the right eye of Jason Maloney. This is trainer Angelo Hyder. You had an opportunity to speak with earlier today, BJ. Nice left hook by Rodriguez that connected. Straight right hand by Rodriguez again. Rodriguez seems to be in control, BJ. It's still a close fight, but Rodriguez is asserting himself as being the more dominant of the two.
Of course, I'm going to say this, Ray. I don't think it's a close fight, but it's a very competitive fight. You know, the first two rounds, Rodriguez dominated these last couple rounds. Maloney's getting closer. He's still losing the rounds, but like I said, it's a competitive fight, but I still have Rodriguez winning almost every round.
It's similar to our last fight. I think the last fight was closer than what we're seeing, but Dorticos established himself early, and then Masternak came on. In this fight, I wonder if Maloney is hoping to do the same.
I mean, I think it's his only shot. He's down probably four rounds already on the scorecards, especially taking into consideration that we're in Florida. So, you know, Maloney's not going to win on the scorecards tonight, though, at the weight, at the the pace this fight's going, so he's going to have to switch it up and do things different a little in the middle rounds.
Stepping in really quick was Maloney with the right hand, using his jab now as he advances forward. But the head, Rodriguez ties up. 70 seconds remaining, round five.
I saw Maloney use his forearm a little bit too on the inside. I actually like that. You know, when a guy's trying to lean his head on you, sometimes you got to use something to gain a little distance. And Maloney just, you know, pushed his head up with that forearm. And referee didn't say anything about it at all. And sometimes, you know, you got to remember it's a fight. Stuff happens.
Maloney's camp, his trainer, they're telling him that Rodriguez is getting tired. They want him to pick up his work rate.
Now, whether it's getting hit or not, you see the intensity on Maloney's face. You know, he didn't come here to lay down and give anything away today. That's for sure, Ray.
Well, when you make that trek from Australia all the way here to South Florida.
Good body shots this round from Maloney. Something we haven't seen yet. Last two rounds have been two, you know, pretty good rounds for Maloney. I don't know if you want him or not, but this round's debatable.
His confidence is growing as we get set for round number six.
Andy, what do you got to go, mate?
And that is his twin brother.
I don't want no power.
That is Jason Maloney's twin brother, Andrew, was also a professional.
Yep. Breathe deep. Slow it down. He's getting tired. Those body shots are beautiful. I want you to stay on the jab, and I want you to get to the body and move out. Right? You're slowing him up with those body shots.
He's starting to breathe.
Set up with the jab. He's puffing. Okay, remember,
round six.
When they get, we get tired, they're a lot worse than us, mate, because we work harder.
Get him out. Let's go.
As we prepare for round six, this one is scheduled for 12. Ray Flores, BJ Flores here ringside at the CFE Arena in Orlando. It is World Boxing Super Series, the Bantamweight quarterfinals. The winner of this matchup will not only win and take home the IBF Bantamweight Championship of the World, but then they have a date against Naoya Inoue, who is the number two seed in the tournament. Inoue is sitting here ringside watching the action.
Some crisp shot punching from Rodriguez to start this round, Ray. Another thing, when you've got a fighter who's continually looking to counter you with this right hand off of your jab, what can you do? You can continue to move to the left and take him, or you can go the other way and go to your right and take that punch out of his arsenal. Not to say that he can't land it at all, but he's going to land it a lot less if you don't go to your left.
Well, Rodriguez knows what is on his shoulders. This has been a downtime for boxing in Puerto Rico. Typically, Puerto Rico always has a few world champions. And boxing since Cotto retired, and it has been, you know, the hurricane hit Puerto Rico. This has been a not so fruitful time for boxing down in Puerto Rico, which is known to have such great quality fighters, Hall of Fame fighters. So Rodriguez not only is fighting for himself, but he's fighting for the island of Puerto Rico, that country, and everything that Puerto Rican boxing stands for.
Nice left hook to the body a second ago by Maloney. You know, I see Maloney really trying to pick up the pace here. Rodriguez landed some very clean punches in the beginning of the round, but the temperament of Maloney is not going anywhere, Ray, and you see he's trying to walk in. If you could just get him to not move to the left while he's moving in, I think he could take away that right hand from Rodriguez. Great counterpunch from Rodriguez. There he goes. Maloney's going the right way now.
Well, he certainly is. And with Maloney, the Maloney twins, the reason why they started boxing was as a way to keep in shape for Australian rules football. So that is why they started to box. And Andrew, his brother, Jason's twin brother, lost his first seven amateur bouts. Jason lost his first three. So it just goes to show you that it is all about your will and your hunger. That for both of these guys to start off their careers or their amateur careers and it not be so prosperous, I think speaks volumes.
Yeah, both guys got a lot of grit, a lot of determination. But, you know, you see that whenever you see him come out in the first round. He takes some good shots. He got hurt a couple times. He got buzzed. And, you know, rounds five and six, he's, like I said, maybe not winning, but he's definitely, you know, pouring on the action. He's doing everything he can to make it a competitive fight with a very good champion.
We are halfway home on this championship affair. And here's some more work. That's a nice left hook.
That's the body half. Get the head and we try more.
Round seven. This one is scheduled for 12. The IBF Bantamweight Championship of the World is on the line between Emmanuel Rodriguez and Jason Maloney, the champion Rodriguez, defending his title against Jason Maloney.
Nice short left hook from Rodriguez a second ago. And you know, Ray, this fight's really starting to change a little bit. You know, the tempo of the fight, Rodriguez is still landing the cleaner punches, but Maloney's definitely getting into this thing. Again, it's maybe not necessarily a close fight, but a very competitive fight. So,
and BJ, as we go and look at the resumes, Rodriguez has been 12 rounds once. Maloney has only been past the eighth one time in his career.
So it'll be very interesting to see what happens as we get into the deeper waters. You know, Andre Ward said it best, the championship fight starts in round six. So it's going to be, see how Maloney, see what his conditioning is like, and then also see, you know, what kind of fortitude he has. Because if he's down, he finds himself down seven rounds going to eight, he's going to have to really buckle down.
Well, I know we're not in Las Vegas, but if Maloney, if it continues this way, he's going to start to have to gamble,
right,
and put himself out there more in order to possibly land big shots. And he just ate a three-punch combination that was punctuated by a straight right hand from Rodriguez.
He did, but he took the punch as well, Ray. Look at him. He's still coming right back on him. You know, Rodriguez, like I said, he's landing the cleaner, harder punches, but the temperament of Maloney is not going to stop anytime soon, and he's been more successful the last few rounds. He's got to switch it up, though. Move to his right. Don't move into the right hand of Rodriguez.
75 seconds left here in round seven.
Nice right hand.
Maloney digging away, and then he comes upstairs with the chopping right hand. Puts the head down to Rodriguez.
And this is the way he's going to win this fight. He's got to go back to the Jeff Harding style. He was an old Australian light heavyweight who wasn't the best boxer. He wasn't the most talented, but he'd have to go inside and maul you. And that's what Maloney's going to have to do tonight if he wants to win. He's going to have to get close to Rodriguez, make him a little tired, and make this a sloppy, tough, rough fight.
Check left hook by Rodriguez. Another one followed by a right hand. Jason Maloney, 27 years of age, said, "I'm going to take on the title at all costs." Nice left hook followed by a piercing straight right hand from Rodriguez.
Rodriguez is so sharp and so calculated. Punches come off so nicely.
They just flow. It literally just flows.
Textbook fundamentals.
Hey, nothing big. Trust me, please. Nothing big. I just want the jab more consistent and more body shots. His legs are going.
His
he's okay? going, guys. We've got to just stay constant in front of him to win the round, our whole game plan, okay?
Some good action from Rodriguez in the last round. Beautiful counter left hook. And again, it looks like Rodriguez is right in front of you, but he shifts. He changes position, and he's able to land those beautiful counter punches.
Round 8 coming up.
Wait for Google. Come on, guys. Get him out. Let's go.
Emmanuel Rodriguez, Jason Maloney. Round 8 here in Orlando. This is the World Boxing Super Series Bantamweight Quarterfinals. The winner takes on Naoya Inoue. And that would be a unification matchup of some sorts, BJ, because Inoue has the WBA bantamweight crown, and the winner of this fight takes home and will be putting the IBF bantamweight championship of the world on the line.
Just got a little mini unification fight set up in a very exciting 118-pound division.
Referee in charge from Poland. Lasek Jedowak will separate the two. Nice right hand that found its destination for Rodriguez. Beautiful head exchange hooks. To be with all of you wherever you're joining us around the world. The World Boxing Super Series, 3 tournaments this season. You have the super lightweights, you have the bantamweights that you're watching here, and the cruiserweights. Next week the attention will shift to the super lightweight division in New Orleans. Nice right hand that smacks off the left side of the head of Maloney. ...65 seconds left in round 8.
Nice uppercut by Maloney. Snuck that in.
Maloney's trainer and his team telling him that they want him to stay tight and straight.
Nice right hand a second ago as well from Rodriguez. Just such a good puncher. He's very, when I say a good puncher, I don't mean he's gonna knock you out with every shot. I mean, his fundamentals are perfect when he's punching. His leverage, his body position is so nice. That's where Maloney's got to work, right there. When he can get the handcuffs on Rodriguez, he's got to take advantage. Because when they're both standing at range, it hasn't gone well for him.
Vamos para el segundo ahí. Dame aire.
No.
¿Cómo nos sentimos ahora? Mejor, ¿verdad?
No. Con calma, Viti, más preciso.
And let's take a look back at some of the work from Emmanuel Rodriguez. A nice right hand right on the button of Jason Maloney. As he had a very good angle, a nice left hook to the body, and Rodriguez really pouring it on Maloney.
Take care of it now.
Let's go, let's go. Stay up the middle. Some short right hands. Then get to the body.
Back here in Orlando, round 9. This one's scheduled for 12. To our eyes, and now the referee in charge, Lasek Jędrzejczyk. There is loose tape from the left glove of Rodriguez. But to our standpoint, BJ, Rodriguez is out comfortably.
Yeah, he is, and I feel like he's, like I said, even though Maloney's been turning up the heat and turning up the pressure the last few rounds, Rodriguez is landing the sharper, cleaner punches, although, you know, you could definitely give Maloney a couple rounds in there, but Rodriguez done the more quality work.
Double left hook by Maloney. And there's a punch stat numbers. Rodriguez and Maloney, very similar, just 21 punches separating the two from being thrown.
Nice left kick by Maloney right there.
Rodriguez answers with a big nice straight right hand.
Get some good body work from Maloney right there. You know, he's a tough kid. It's round nine. He's down on the scorecards, probably, you know, 6-2, maybe 7-1 even, but he's very game and he's trying to turn this fight around. And, you know, like his corner says, if Rodriguez is taking his foot off the gas a little bit, that's Maloney's nice overhand right by Maloney. That's a great situation for Maloney to turn the tables here in the ninth round. I mean, he has not given up.
No, Maloney is giving his all. But he's finding someone who is more fundamentally sound
right
than him.
Correct. You know, the better fighter always doesn't win, though, Ray. In this particular situation, it looks like Rodriguez is, you know, cruising his way. It's not an easy fight, mind you. It might look easy from the outside, but it's not. But sometimes the tougher guy, the guy with the determination, can win the fight in the end, although it doesn't appear that way. But a fight can change in one punch.
And Jason Maloney certainly does have a propensity. 14 of his 17 wins have come by knockout. Also, let us not forget, neither man has suffered a defeat in their professional careers.
A lot of confidence, that means. It means he's never lost. He doesn't know how to lose, and he doesn't believe he can lose. So until that 12th round and that final bell rings, you can't tell Jeff Maloney otherwise, and you see the type of temperament, the kind of belief he has in himself right here.
Jason Maloney's want to scrap it, and they want to just go to battle. Big right hand punctuating the round for Rodriguez.
Beautiful right hand by Rodriguez. He's so sharp, isn't he?
And now the glove is loose again. This time, though, it's the right glove. Or the left glove, I stand correct.
We did brief that this is a tight fight. There's two rounds for you to win this title, okay?
You can fucking do this, Dave.
It's a tight fight.
You can do it, all right?
Close your eye for me. Do not stand still in front of him. Keep it working.
And this is Rodriguez earlier, BJ.
Yeah, landed some good shots. I mean, we talk about it every round. He's just such a sharp counterpuncher. And here we see Maloney kind of coming forward a little bit, missing with the body shot, and good left hook from Rodriguez, and Maloney continuing to bang away. Great action.
There was a sharp right hand, bang, look at that, and Maloney took it well.
Kind of a corking left uppercut, and then a sharp right hand.
Let's
right
on the money.
This is the second time in his professional career that Jason Maloney has been to the 10th. For Rodriguez, he has been 12 just once in his professional campaign.
I mean, Maloney had a good round nine, Ray. I thought he was very competitive. Don't think he won the round again, but you know, he comes forward, he fights hard, he's very competitive so far. He's got to be careful for that right hand to Rodriguez.
And for Rodriguez, he won this title against Paul Butler back on May 5th overseas in England. The fighter Maloney, he won this opportunity by defeating Coheed Kano back on May 19th.
Yeah, and really a fight that Rodriguez went over to the UK and dominated over Paul Butler, a guy who was, you know, well revered over there, a guy who a lot of people respected, and Rodriguez really had his way with him.
Round 10, this one is scheduled for 12. Ray Flores, BJ Flores here in Orlando. In the second season of the World Boxing Super Series, this is a bantamweight quarterfinal matchup. The winner punches their ticket against Naoya Inoue in the semifinals. And now Maloney just going to work. He has the head in his chest. of Rodriguez and unloading on the body of Rodriguez.
Very important. Maloney keeps his head in good position wise on the inside because that doesn't allow Rodriguez to get in position to punch. So head position and head placement is very important for Maloney when he's on the inside with such a good puncher like Rodriguez. Nice right uppercut.
And Lasek Janowak warning Rodriguez. As we come up on a minute to go here in round 10. Rodriguez and Maloney are just fighting on sheer guts and will at this moment. Nice uppercut that found a home by Rodriguez. Maloney came forward and Rodriguez snuck in a right uppercut.
See Maloney trying to use that left forearm to get a little separation, to get a little distance. Missed the shot, but if he would have went to the body, nice body shot by Maloney. That's what the corner Maloney wants him to do here. Attack the body, and you see for the first time Rodriguez starting to be pushed back a little bit. Finally starting to show a little bit of a crack in his armor. We haven't seen it the entire fight, but the constant pressure of Maloney might finally be starting to get to Rodriguez.
Maloney fighting at a feverish pace. Rodriguez trying to tie up the Australian.
Wow.
We're headed towards the championship rounds.
You see some good work by Maloney right there, working very hard on the inside and, you know, really having a little bit of a momentum swing there in the night in the 10th round. You know, you saw him continually getting outpunched and finally showing a little bit of fatigue, Rodriguez, and rightfully so.
And look at Maloney. There's that big uppercut by the Australian man. That was like he teed that up from the land down under and brought it with a ferocity. Wherever you are joining us, thank you so much. And I am sure you are enjoying this compelling matchup between Manuel Rodriguez and Jason Maloney. The championship rounds, round 11. Scheduled for 12. The IBF Bantamweight Championship is on the line. The champion Rodriguez taking on the challenger in Maloney. Both fighters are undefeated. The winner advances to the semifinals against Aoya Inoue.
Nice right uppercut by Rodriguez a second ago. Snapped the head of Maloney back. But then you see Maloney continuing to put pressure, walking back, hits him with a straight jab. That's the punch they wanted him to use. And
a big right hand that connected by Rodriguez.
But for one thing, Rodriguez, as good of a counterpuncher as he is, he's starting to slow that down a little bit. I don't know if it's fatigue or what exactly it is. The timing of Maloney is starting to put a little more pressure. He's getting closer without Rodriguez giving him anything back. Nice right hand by Maloney and some good body work here.
Maloney now is going right to work on Rodriguez. And if you're Rodriguez, he can't get complacent because who knows? Judging can be all over the board, BJ.
I mean, I doubt any judge has Rodriguez down at this point, but, you know, he can't get complacent because you don't want to let Maloney get too much momentum. He's coming on strong right here in the corner of Maloney. He's been yelling it for the last three rounds. Rodriguez is tired. They keep yelling, and we can't help but hear it. Nice right uppercut, right body shot by Maloney.
Look at this work between these two world-class bantamweights. As the fans here cheering on both combatants here in Orlando. It's the World Boxing Super Series Bantamweight quarterfinals between Emmanuel Rodriguez and Jason Maloney.
Maloney's doing some really good work in this round, Ray. Been very busy, and you see a fatigued Rodriguez starting to absorb a lot of these shots that before he was able to counterpunch.
It's a battle of attrition. It's a long fight. And Maloney had hoped if he continued to pressure him, that he would have some moments in there where maybe, just maybe, he'd be able to take advantage and land a big shot.
Maloney is so hungry, so determined, feels that it is his destiny to win a world title for Emmanuel Rodriguez. He's been heaped upon with a lot of praise, feeling those around him that he could be the next big superstar out of Puerto Rico. But first, he has to get past Jason Maloney. And two right hands for Rodriguez as we near the end of the 11th round. One more left in this world championship matchup and this quarterfinal affair.
Fantastic round for Maloney.
And there is Naoya Inoue. That is who awaits the winner. You know, he's in a good mood now, but inside the ropes, he's not a nice person.
He's not the nicest guy we've seen inside the ropes, is he, right? Devastating puncher, and you know, I tell you what, he's going to have his hands full with either guy. The winner of this fight is going to be a very challenging test for Inoue.
He's the monster for a reason, but right now, we are going to see who is going to fight the monster. Emmanuel Rodriguez. Or Jason Maloney, the 12th and final round. Here in Orlando. They are both slugging it out here. It is a Saturday Night Slugfest here in South Florida.
Beautiful work by Maloney on the inside. He just got caught with a good right uppercut, but he's back to work, banging away on the body. You know, it's obvious that Rodriguez is a little tired here, and Maloney's working harder than him right now, but still got to be careful not to get hit with anything big.
But there's some blood on the back of Rodriguez. Accidental headbutt, so says referee in charge of the second gentleman. Thankfully that happened as we only have 2 minutes and 15 seconds remaining.
And you see Maloney almost sprinting out of his corner and banging on the body of Rodriguez. Red Rodriguez is tired, look at this.
He is just going there. This is why the World Boxing Super Series is so compelling, so entertaining. You never know what you're going to get out of these draws.
And Maloney's actually the harder puncher right now. He's got more juice. He's got more zip. He's landing the cleaner, harder shots at this moment. Nice right hand by Maloney.
Maloney has more juice behind his shots. But Rodriguez is not to be denied. Echoing left hooks by the Australian and Maloney. Rodriguez coming forward. Both fan bases are on the edge of their seats.
Nice left hook by Maloney.
Another, he bends away in the body of Rodriguez. Rodriguez trying to stay tight. Big champion, another one. But Rodriguez answers with an echoing right hand. 118 pounds is so riveting.
Beautiful
body work. These two fighters have really poured and gave their heart and soul inside this ring.
They both put it all on the line tonight, Ray. Rodriguez was in control early by a lot, and you know, this is why they fight all 12 rounds, and this is why they fight the fight.
Win or lose, sign me up to see both. Look at this.
Maloney is there, and he's not going away easily, and you got to respect this tough-as-nails Australian coming over here to Florida and fighting in Rodriguez's hometown.
Rodriguez puts Maloney. What we are watching is beautiful violence inside the World Boxing Super Series ring. This is beautifully violent, but it is sure as heck so entertaining at the world-class level.
And Rodriguez is definitely ready for that final bell to land. Nice right hook by Maloney in the last seconds.
What a fight between the champion Emmanuel Rodriguez and Jason Maloney.
Outstanding.
What a fight here in Orlando.
outstanding matchup finally comes to an end between Rodriguez and Maloney. Taking a look at some of the action here in the 12th round, Maloney really digging in. Outpunched Rodriguez probably 2 or 3 to 1 in that final round. Was very busy and definitely got the champion's attention. Really came on strongly during the last 3 to 4 rounds in this fight. Really swinging for the fences there. Maloney misses the big shot, but the temperament and the persistence of Maloney, you see him getting to Rodriguez some of those body shots. A lot of good work from two very, very tough fighters. Yeah, sure. And now let's take it up to ringside with Ray Flores.
Ladies and gentlemen, please give both fighters a round of applause for 12 exciting rounds of championship action. Having gone the distance, we go to the scorecards. Here are your score totals. Judge at ringside, Holger Whiteman, has the contest 115-113 for Maloney. Judge Alfredo Polanco has it 115-113 for Rodriguez. And Judge Alexander Levin scores the bout 115-113 for your winner by split decision. Moving on to the World Boxing Super Series Bantamweight semifinals. And still, IBF Bantamweight Champion of the World, Emmanuel Manny El Sensacional Rodriguez.
Wow. A split decision determined by one single point. On the final judges' scorecards, 115-113 Maloney, 115-113 Rodriguez, and the final and deciding judge, 115-113 Maloney.
Let's have a word with Emmanuel Manny Rodriguez. Emmanuel, congratulations on the victory. What are your thoughts on the W against Jason Maloney? ¿Qué piensas con esta victoria contra Jason Maloney?
No fue una victoria. Una pelea bien dura. Gracias a Moroni por dar la batalla que dio. Sabíamos que íbamos con un buen peleador. Nos dio la batalla. Pero pues, como siempre dije, el ganador iba a ser yo. Gracias a Dios salimos victoriosos. Ahora pues, a descansar y para la próxima ronda, si Dios lo permite.
He said that it was a good fight. He takes Maloney to bring the best of him. He know he wins the fight and he gonna take his team too.
Were you surprised that the fight was as close as it was on the scorecards? Pensaste que la pelea era muy cerquita en las tarjetas de los jueces.
Sí, sabía que había sido una pelea cerrada, pero mi esquina siempre me dijo que estaba cerrada la pelea, pero que estaban adelante. Y los últimos dos rounds estaba un poco cansado y me mandaron a boxear y pude, eso quizás esos asaltos que boxeé bien, quizás usando la maña, pues fueron los asaltos clave.
We know the fight was close, but my corner always tell me that I was in front, so I give my best, and this is what happened.
And now let's bring in the WBA Bantamweight Champion of the World, Naoya Inoue. Naoya, come forward. Emmanuel, give us your thoughts about fighting this man, the monster. What are your thoughts after he destroyed Juan Carlos Payano? But what are your initial thoughts about fighting Naoya Inoue in the semifinals of the World Boxing Super Series Bantamweight Tournament?
¿Cuáles son tus pensamientos después de haber visto el knockout aparatoso que dio Naoya a Payano? ¿Cómo te sientes que enfrentarlo a él ahora?
No, no, él es un boxeador de alto calibre. Es un boxeador que acaba las peleas, como todo el mundo se lo ha dicho, es un tremendo peleador, sus méritos se los ha ganado. Él cuando ganó su victoria hace 2 semanas atrás, pues dijo que con quien le gustaría enfrentarme era a mí. Y pues ya, yo gané, pues si Dios lo permite, el año que viene, para febrero, no sé la fecha, pues nos enfrentaríamos y pues será la batalla que todo el mundo está esperando.
He said he's a tough fighter. He knows that he likes to finish his bouts with a knockout. He also knows that he asking for fighting for the next fight. And he said that's going to be a good fight. So he's waiting for the fight.
Emmanuel, thank you. Now let's join alongside by Naoya Inoue, the monster who has been destroying his competition. We saw him 2 weeks ago. Naoya, what is your takeaway from watching Emmanuel Rodriguez in his fight against Jason Maloney?
今日の試合を見ての感想どうでしたか。まず今日の勝利をおめでとうと言いたいです。
First, I would like to congratulate Rodriguez for winning this fight tonight.
Well, you got your wish in Tokyo. You said you wanted to fight Emmanuel Rodriguez. Now you have your wish. How excited are you to take on this man in the semifinals of the World Boxing Super Series Bantamweight Tournament?
横浜でロドリゲスと 準決勝で戦いたいと言ってましたけど、実際現実となって今どう思ってますか。実際にロドリゲスが勝ち上がってきて、来年準決勝で戦えることをすごく非常にワクワクします。I'm really excited that I'll be facing Rodriguez in the semifinals probably early next year.
We cannot wait for that one. Now we are going to get them to pose off, ladies and gentlemen. The IBF Bantamweight Champion of the World, Naoya Inoue, the WBA Bantamweight Champion of the World, Callis Sutherland, right there. This is the semifinals of the World Boxing Super Series Bantamweight Tournament. As we have Emmanuel Rodriguez, Naoya Inoue. What a fight this is going to be in 2019. Inoue Rodriguez, the Bantamweights, look at this showdown. In 2019, all thanks to the World Boxing Super Series.
A fantastic win for Emmanuel Rodriguez, holding on to his title via split decision over a very, very game and very tough Jason Maloney. He came to fight tonight, and now we have a huge matchup to look forward to between Rodriguez and a very tough Japanese challenger in Inoue coming up in the next quarter.